the number one fishing port in America, New Bedford, Massachusetts. Welcome to the Paul Santos Live Show. Tonight's guests are wonderful entertainer Roger Chartier.
Roger Chartier. Roger Dodger.
Very funny comic Jerry Caruso.
Jerry.
And up-and-coming singer Skyla Swire. Plus, Gary Langevin, Artie DeMello. It's the PSL Band.
Thank you, Allison. Thank you very much. Welcome, everyone. Welcome.
And me. I'm Allison Dian. Hello, and thank you for watching. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the host of our show, Paul Santos!
Hello and welcome to our show! How's everybody doing tonight?
Yeah!
Well, as you know, we highlight not only the talented, not only the interesting, but yes, the entertaining from our area. You heard that fantastic list by Allison. Big show tonight, Allison.
I know.
How are you doing tonight?
And I almost got everyone's name right.
And how about the best band in all the land, Gary and Ari, a PSL band. There they are.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you very much. Thanks,
all
everybody.
Right. Thank you. Well, we are going to have a lot of fun tonight. If you're watching on ABC 6 in Providence, I've got one thing to say to you. Good Sunday morning to you.
Top of the morning to you.
Don't forget, the Catholic Mass is on right after this. We might have to be repenting before we're done with this, especially after the monologue. Channel 95, good evening. And if you're watching the live stream, type something in, say hello, and we'll get right back to you. We like to be interactive, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, interactive, say hello, type, that kind of thing. All right, let's get caught up in the news. What do you think?
Let's do it.
You always say, do it.
You're my only source of news, Paul.
Oh, all right. Well, you know, there's an interesting news item out of New Bedford. A mobile-free public library is cruising around New Bedford. Isn't that cool? I mean, it's a bus of books that's driving around New Bedford. Or as I refer to it, Deals on Wheels. You know, the kids, they're trying to get them to read, you know, and all that. Remember in the old days, reading is fundamental and all that, yeah. You know? So driving around with the books. Hey, are we on the same page here? Now, so I'm picturing this, right? When we were kids, right? You know, we had a neighborhood with a lot of kids, and, you know, like the pony boy would pull up and stuff like that, ding, ding, ding. But I'm picturing, how's this going to work? Like the bus of books is going to pull up, and it's like, Jimmy, put down the video game. The books are here, you know.
Don't judge a book by its cover, folks, whatever you do.
Put that book down. I mean, don't put the book down. Put the video games down.
Put the video games down and pick up a book, lad.
Hey, by the way, the New Bedford mayor is in the news, John Mitchell, you know? Yeah, John Mitchell's in the news. He's opposing a plan that is going to close that federal building in downtown New Bedford. And I agree with him. He's really upset about that. I mean, he's mad. He's really mad.
How mad is he?
He's so mad, even the pigeons are staying clear of City Hall. All right, so how about a joke in bad taste? You want to try one of those?
Huh? I love those.
did he just say a joke in bad taste?
Yeah, joking bad taste.
As opposed to...
All right, well, let's try it here. Speaking of bad taste, Crazy Casey is here tonight.
Oh, Big Daddy.
We missed you, Big Daddy.
Yeah, I'm glad to see that you're feeling a little bit better. You know, we just came back from a doctor's appointment. Did you know that?
Yeah.
he went to the doctor, and he had his colonoscopy, but he's feeling better now. The pain is rectified.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Just make sure you pay it forward on the back end, will
you? Well, you know, Allison was saying how we're the number one fishing port in America.
We are.
That's right. Number one in all of America, New Bedford, Massachusetts. Well, imports of Japanese scallops are actually going to be cutting into the seafood industry. When I heard that, I thought one thing. Oh, my Godzilla! Oh.
I mean...
Crazy Casey's like, hey, as long as I can go to the bar and get a kamikaze, I don't care.
That's right, man. That's right.
Hey, let's talk about health. Health is big, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
You know who's really healthy? Gary. Gary's slim, trim.
I am the epitome of a 50-year-old man in fabulous health. That's right, 50, everybody. Well, I know it's hard to believe.
Woo!
It's hard to believe. Thank you.
50 and fabulous?
50 and fabulous and single.
Oh, wow.
And filthy.
Hey, Juicy Brucey, did you hear that?
Rich, not just me. Hey, do you leave Juicy Brucey alone?
No. Anyway. They had this diet here, intermittent fasting, you know, where you'd eat dinner at like 5 o'clock and then not eat anything again for a whole 24-hour period. Well, now they're saying that intermittent fasting actually causes heart attacks. Imagine that.
Oh, wow.
Can somebody pass me the malasadas, please? I'm with this thing.
That's right. Extra butter.
Pass me the french fries. Send me some donuts now. Hey, speaking of donuts, the New Bedford police are in the news, you know? I got to be in good standing with the police after I leave Mikey B's. Well, anyway, the New Bedford police are actually joining TikTok in order to try to find new recruits. Imagine that. The New Bedford police on TikTok.
Are you kidding me?
So an older person said to me, TikTok, isn't that a place where, like, arrests can go viral? I said, yeah, it's also a place where Arrested Development goes viral.
You know.
All right, let's go to Providence to find some humor, you know. If we don't find any down here, we can go to Providence. Find
yeah,
some humor.
Definitely.
Three Providence restaurants did not get their liquor licenses renewed. Imagine that. So then one of the restaurant owners said, Mr. Mayor, I don't understand it. That church down there and the priest, he doesn't have to get a liquor license. The mayor said, yeah, but he turns water into wine.
Maybe we should cut. All right, we're going to do that take one more time, everybody, okay? Now, the point is to laugh after the joke.
There are people actually laughing. Don't break the momentum. Let it sit. Hey, you know what? Here's a good one for you. This is actually true. One of our comics said, you should tell people things that really happened to you. So this really happened to me, right? My electric razor broke. You know, I like to use electric razors. You know, my dad used to use that thing, you know, come at you with a straight razor. No. I always like the convenience of an electric razor. So mine broke. So I go to the store. I'm thinking, you know, you get Remington, you get Norelco. Oh, no. I go to the store. There's an entire aisle of one razor after another. All these different choices for this and that and the other thing and all that. I'm thinking, which one am I going to buy? So I'm looking at this one, looking at that one. I'm going, oh, wait a minute. I know which one I'm going to get. I'm Portuguese. I'm going to get this one, the lawnmower.
That one was very, very personal.
I had to get one because the one I have now is kind of like, you know, that kind of thing. So anyway. Well, I'm sorry to bring you this sad news here, Gary. I've got some really bad news.
No.
I know it's the saddest moment of the night.
Oh, my God. Let everybody.
But now I'm going to bring you the final joke of the night.
The final joke.
You know, Gary does languages, right? You do an English accent. Do you do an Irish accent?
Yeah.
Can I hear the Irish accent?
But you're going to do the real one, though, like the Gaelic. You don't really understand what they're saying. So you're
yeah, right, exactly. And same to you. No, actually, Ireland is in the news. You know that? The Ireland prime minister, he had to step down due to political pressure. So somebody said to him, Mr. Prime Minister, top of the morning? He said, no, more like I got it in the bottom.
Bow!
The final
joke. Are the guests still here?
They're still here.
The guests are still here. Okay, all right. We have a great show for you tonight. All right, that's what I'm talking about. Can I get a yeah, baby mama?
Yeah, baby mama.
All right, we have a great show for you tonight. We'd like to thank our sponsors. How about Mikey B's? That's where we're coming from right now.
Yeah. Mikey B's.
How about J&J Materials and our good friend John Ferreira? Our thanks to attorney John B.C., a good friend of mine. Our thanks to our comedy director, the owner and operator, the CEO of Dying for Laughs, Allison Dian.
When
she does that thing, it looks better than when I do it.
Yeah, it looks much better than when you do it.
Oh, my goodness. It doesn't look good when I do it. Let's see. Surf Pro from Dartmouth, New Bedford. Yes.
Surf Pro. Let them clean it up.
Special thanks to our good friend Sharon Jensen and Alden Court.
Sharon Jensen.
And the person who puts the lights, the camera, the action together from Bristol County Media, Mr. Aaron Cadju.
Aaron the Baron.
Thanks to you, Paul. No Portuguese guys are ever allowed to do Irish accents ever again.
That's right. Amen to that. Thanks, Paul.
Ah, that's right, Aaron Cadju. I tell you, he's right. A riot, isn't he? I'll tell you that right
he
now.
He's
a riot, all right. All right, we have a great show, and we start in just a moment. We have Jerry Caruso, we have Skyla Swire, and Roger Shaddy are all coming up. It's the Paul Stanzo's live show. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back right after this message. Right now, say hello to the best band in all the land. It's Gary Langer and Artie DeMello and the PSL Band. We are joined by John Ferreira of J&J Materials out here in Rehoboth, Massachusetts. John, always good to see you.
Thank you. Always good to see you, too.
You know, I know you've had great success here in your business. How did you get into this particular business?
I bought this property and decided to open a little retail yard, you know, something small for small contractors. And the J&J came from my two kids, John and Janelle.
How long have you had this business?
So J&J opened in 1993, Nantucket Pavers, 1996. We manufacture and sell patio block to Home Depot in 48 states. And turned into a pretty huge operation, as you can see. We got 5 stores, 2 in Rhode Island, 3 in Massachusetts, and we're the largest landscape supplier in southeastern Mass and Rhode Island. We've always got good staff and over 100 employees. And I've got a lot of people that have been with me over 30 years.
How much inventory do you have here?
So J&J has on pretty much at all times between $5 and $6 million worth of pavers, stone, mulch, landscape supplies, masonry supplies, cultured stone for chimneys, anything you need for your home.
You also have trucks coming and going all the time.
Yes. Oh yeah. There's trucks picking up aggregates, picking up stone, Bach mulch, screen loom. You know, a lot of mason contractors come for their mason sand and their cement. So yeah, it's a busy place from the bringing in the material to getting it delivered to the home to servicing and selling the customer. It's all very important. You know, if you need landscape supplies, come to J&J.
Oh yeah, it's the king of the keys. And the guy with that sweet saxophone, Gary Artie, the PSL Band. Let's hear it for those guys.
Thanks again, Paul. Thank you.
All right, we got a few shout-outs here. Of course, she's one of our top followers, and we love to say hello to her because she's always the first one in from Niagara Falls, New York. Hey, Lynn Marie Scrivano, thank you for looking in tonight. Always glad to have you looking in. And here's one of our bigger fans from Dartmouth, Massachusetts. They used to call him the mayor of Round Hill because he used to walk around Round Hill like he owned the place, you know. Really good guy, Don Willis.
Don,
thank you for looking in tonight.
Fantastic. All right.
And by the way, I'm looking around the house here tonight. The cases are here. Nate and Grace, thank you for looking in.
Hello, friends.
You know, Nate came in first, and it looked like we were going to have half a case, but now we got a full case. Yeah. I'm sure Casey's happy about that. Right. And how about Juicy Brucey? Hey, Juicy.
Juicy Brucey.
Hey, Juicy, tell me the truth. Are you still Juicy after all these years?
Oh, that's gross. That's gross. That's the grossest question you've ever asked. That's so gross.
No, I'm just asking a question.
I know, but Juicy.
I think he is. I think he's still Juicy after
well, good
all
thing
these
you don't
years.
Call him
oh,
Lucy
look who just
Brucey.
Came in here. Annette Almeida. Right, Annette, how are you?
Yes, love her.
Hey, we
got to
have you back on the show real soon. We love you. We love you, Annette Almeida. Okay. Well, we got a guy backstage. We gave him a backstage pass, and he's been hanging out back there all this time. So it's about time we introduced him. He's been an entertainer for a long time, and he can really get people kind of singing along and stuff like that. We like to do that. We like to do sing-alongs. So, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for New Bedford's own Roger Shaddier.
I've been back there for 6.5 hours waiting for this show to start. I don't know what's going on. I don't know. Is this going to work? Let's try it like
sure,
this.
All right, go ahead. That's perfect.
How does that sound?
Perfect.
Well, she was just 17. You know what I mean. And the way she looked, way beyond compare. I'll never dance with another. Woo! When I saw her standing there, well, she looked at me, and I could see that before too long, I fell in love with her. I'll never dance with another. Woo! When I saw her standing there, well, my heart went boom, wow, when I crossed that room, and I held her hand in my heat. Oh, we danced through the night, and we held each other tight, and before too long, I fell in love with her. I'll never dance with another. Woo! When I saw her standing there, since I saw her standing there. Yay!
Yeah.
Yay! Bravo, bravo! Oh my God!
Roger Chatier.
I was waiting to get called on, I tell you.
Come on down, come on down. Hand that over to Handy Randy Dandy over there.
Handy Dandy
Randy. Grab a seat. Thank you very much.
I
hope so. We don't want anything to happen to it.
Oh, let me get this. El microphone.
So thanks a lot for stopping down here tonight. I really appreciate it.
I stopped down, and Annette's here, and Leo Dumas is here. And
yeah.
I've known this guy for a million years.
Which guy?
That guy right there.
Crazy Casey?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He had a bar downtown, and so did I. That's how we knew each other. I get hammered in his bar, and he come to mine once in a blue moon.
Well, Crazy Casey, you know, he likes to throw a few back once in a while, you know?
Yeah. That's a good thing.
It's a good thing.
You keep lubricated, and you function better, you know?
All right, get that a little bit closer. And
like this?
Yes, yeah, nice deep voice. Radio,
alrighty, then.
Radio voice.
I've got the radio voice.
So you've been an entertainer for a long time.
A long
time. DJed, singing, the whole thing, right?
Yeah.
So tell me about that.
Well, I started, I was 14 years old, and I could walk already, but anyway, yeah, so I started playing when I was 14, and I got in bands in 1966. I did my first gig with a band, and then I played in bands, then I went on the road, and we're on the road for 12 years straight on the road, playing all big clubs in New England, small clubs in New England. It was exciting, though, you know, it's fun. And then I stopped going on the road, and I worked around here, and I did audio. I did concert PA work. And I got into television, and I did television. I did maybe 30, 35 Bruins games. Did sound, you know? Set up, like, play-by-play color and all of that stuff.
Oh,
you
no,
know?
So I didn't know. Yeah, I'm a big Bruins fan.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I did boxing. I did bull riding.
At the Old Garden, right?
No, bull riding in Worcester.
Mm-hmm.
I did all kinds of stuff, and I worked on 3 unplugged shows, MTV unplugged shows.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
You have a better resume than I thought.
Well, I've done a lot of stuff.
That's great. That's awesome.
I got my pilot's license. I can fly an airplane. I love flying, but I haven't done it recently. It's expensive.
Did it expire? Did the license expire?
No, it never expires. You just have to get your physical every 2 years. If you're healthy, and if you're like me, it's every year.
Hasn't been suspended or anything?
No. I haven't been suspended yet, thank God, you know.
So you fly those small little Cessnas, right?
Yeah, Cessna, 4-seat, 172s, 150 horsepower.
You know, a friend of mine had his pilot's license, Johnny J, if you're watching tonight. Yeah. And when you first get in one of those things, it's pretty small and scary, you know.
A 152 is a 2-seater, 100 horsepower engine, and that's like a small sports car in the air. You're small up there, you know.
When you first get your license, you have to do a stall of the engine and see if you can get out of it, right?
Oh, yeah. I do it many times.
On purpose?
Yeah, you go out over Hossnack Beach so you don't kill anybody if you crash. and then so you do a thing where you climb, and then you're going straight up, and the engine can't handle it anymore, and you get the throttle off. The engine can't handle it, and you drop, and you got to recover before you lose 200 feet of altitude.
Yeah.
Over and over and over again you do that until you know it inside and out.
Doesn't it seem like something that's a little bit too much to ask a person who's trying to get a pilot's license?
A regular
license?
Guy? Oh, yeah. The things they make you do. It's beautiful, though. I love flying a plane. It's the most wonderful thing.
All right, compared to entertaining. You know, entertaining, that's really
that's
in your blood, right?
That's number one. You know, I was talking to Allison. Allison's over there. There she is. Yay! Yes. And I used to do a comedy show. I played in Berlin, New Hampshire.
You're a comedian, too?
No. But I did 20 minutes of jokes in French, and I can't remember I remember only one in French. So for all the French audience out there, I don't hear any answers. There's no French audience. So what do I do?
Oui.
Combien d'Américains s'en prend pour changer la globe? Ça prend trois. Un pour tenir la globe et deux pour tourner l'escabeau.
All I got out of that was something about a glove.
I changed the light bulb. Oh. To hold the bulb, two to turn the ladder. No, but that was like the kind of thing I did up in Berlin, New Hampshire, up there close to, side by each to Canada there, up there.
Canada.
Terre de mes aïeux. Oh, okay. We won't do that.
Well, in addition to, you know, obviously you started here with a cover song of the Beatles. Great, great selection.
Yeah.
You also write some stuff, right?
Oh, yeah. I've got two CDs out. And it's funny because I don't play sea shanties ever, but I made a CD of sea shanties. I probably did three gigs with sea shanties, so it didn't really pay off to promote my gigs, you know? But I did, I've got two CDs of sea shanties. One of them is half sea shanties, half not, you know? But it's interesting stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, they're exciting. It's exciting music. If you're in the 1800s, it was just the rock and roll of the day, you know?
I don't think you went back that far.
Oh, no. I'm only 73, you know.
Oh, wow, 73. You look great.
Yay, yeah, Roger's 73. Can you believe it? Look at his face.
Hey, Gary, we can do the show another 15, 20 years.
I was born in 1973, I'll have you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow.
I was born in 19... Yeah, and he's a young buck.
He's a young
just
buck.
Just a wee lad.
You were a wee lad, you were, eh?
Hey. Artie wasn't born in 1983.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, good for you, though.
For Medicare.
They got a new program for Medicare.
And what's that?
They have an outpatient and inpatient sex therapy.
Oh, wow. I got to sign up for that. I got to sign up for that.
Casey already signed up for that.
Yeah, he's already been thrown out. I don't know how that works.
All right, now, you want to do a couple of songs that you wrote. So tell me about the songs that you wrote.
Oh, one of them is Lady. It's a slow
lady.
Song.
Lady.
Make you cry.
Oh.
No, it's not a make you cry song. But Lady, and the other one is I Want to Go to Heaven.
Well, we're going to need a little help on
that
one.
That's going to be a joke. I'll never get there. Hey, he's a Gaelic guy, huh?
Gaelic. Gaelic. Oh, my goodness gracious. Yeah, I got to get a little Gaelic in me. What of it?
Shemalek machilimar.
I'll even don't make me bust out my clogs, and I'll come out and I'll do some river dancing.
All right. Bada bing, bada boom.
Hey, you know, if you played center for the Montreal Canadiens, you'd be Roger Chartier.
I'd be Roger Chartier.
Coming down the wing.
In Paris, you gargle your R's. Roger Chartier.
Oh, I never thought of that.
Oh, yeah, but in Canada, au Canada, les terres de mes aïeux, you... Roll your eyes. Hey, Roger Chartier.
Hey, Arthur, have you ever gargled an R before?
Never
mind. Don't answer that. All right, would you like to do those two songs
right,
now?
All right,
grab
what
the...
What the
let's
heck?
Get the...
If you can't hear my guitar, that's because I forgot
guitar,
to bring a guitar
and
cord.
He's gonna do
I've got millions of them.
Those two songs, he's going to put them together kind of like a medley. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, let's put your hands together for a fantastic entertainer, Roger Chartier! There he is.
Oh, that's good. All right. All right. All right,
Roger's going to sing for us. And a shout out to John and Debbie Oliver. Thanks for watching tonight.
Watch me.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there.
Now we're talking.
Oh, look at that. Isn't that cool? Have you ever seen a Beatles concert? Every time they get on stage, the microphones are all screwed
that's
up.
All I know is if you break it, you own it. That's all.
Yeah, that's
Artie's motto.
See, look.
How did that come in? It's a conspiracy.
It's a communist plot.
It is.
That was that Medicare thing that Artie's doing. Things stop falling off, you know.
That's one of the complicated. That's one of the.
You know, this mic clip is no good, but that's all right. You fix
it. All right, here we go. Let's go.
Here we go. Let's
all
do
right,
it.
We don't have time to fool around here.
Oh, here we go.
All right, here
all
we
right,
go.
Now we're talking.
Let's see, can you hear me? Can you see me? All right.
Sure.
Lady, I never fell in love with you. Jumped in head first was all I could do. keep from drowning there. When you got too near, oh, lady, I never fell in love with you. Lady, I never gave my heart to you. Let it go, it was all I could do. To keep from dying there. When you got too near, oh, lady, I never fell in love. Lady, I never fell in love. Lady, I never fell in love with you. First time I saw you was when I needed you most. Then you told me you were giving up the ghost. Lady, I never fell in love. Lady, I never fell in love, oh, oh, lady, I never fell in love with you. C, key of C. Wanna go to heaven, wanna talk to the man, hallelujah, till we meet again. When I get to heaven, gonna give him my plan, hallelujah, till we meet again. Bye, bye. Honey, don't you cry. If I ain't back in a couple of days, you know I went the other, you know I went the other, you know I went the other way. Ta-da!
Yay! Roger Scheider, thanks a lot for being on the show tonight. We'll be right back with comedy. It's the Paul Santos Live Show. Please stay with us. Gary watching from London, England. Andrea Ryan.
Hello, love.
Shout out to Don Silva. Thanks for looking in tonight. Kevin Robertson says, hi, Allison.
Hi.
And Don Silva says, hey, that last guy's pretty funny. That's true. Bruce Sears says, I thought we were at Alden Court tonight. Well, we switched it up. It's okay.
We are.
We're going to go back there real soon. Real soon. Joseph Montero says, hi, Chops. That's okay. We pass a message along the Chops. And Deb Ramos, thanks for looking in tonight. Hey, Luke, who's over here? It's the director of comedy. It's Allison Dian.
Hi. Hi. Thank you.
Great to see you tonight. How's everything going with you?
Everything's going great. I am actually performing in the Boston Comedy Festival this week.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's this whole week. They're kicking it off tonight. Obviously, I can't be there because I am here. But I'm competing in preliminary round number 5 on Wednesday, 7 p.m. at City Winery.
Fantastic. Good for you. Good
so
for
yeah.
you.
Yeah. So if you're in the Boston area, come check it out. It's going to be awesome.
We were so excited when you passed along the information that they had selected you. Really, really great. How did that all happen?
Yeah. Well, so you apply, and they get hundreds and hundreds of applications every year. Then they narrow it down to, I believe it's 72. And they have 6 preliminary rounds. That narrows it down to 36. And then I think they narrow it down to 6 in the semifinal round. So I think about 6 people go on to the finals.
So you made that first cut. All right. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I'm so excited. And we have had a few comedians that have been on this show that also got into the festival.
Yeah, nice, nice.
Yeah. So Tim Ciampa, who was here recently, he's in the festival. And also Sam Pelletier,
I love him.
Who is here. And luckily, I am not in the preliminary round with either of those two guys. Otherwise, I'd be scared. But there is somebody in my preliminary round that has actually done late night TV, like Jimmy Kimmel Live.
Wow, nice. Wow.
The competition is tough.
Yeah, nice. Well, good for you. I think that's fantastic. All the best. And
thank you.
Hopefully you get past that first round and onward you go.
Exactly. And I have one more thing I wanted to promote. As I am actually going to be an opening act for one of your friends, Joey Terenza, who's a Frank Sinatra tribute artist.
Yes, that's right.
So I'm going to be opening for him at the Sons of Italy on April 28th in Quincy.
Nice, nice. All right, good for you. Good for you.
Thanks.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. Well, anyway, we have a comedian here. You know, one of the things that we love about having Allison here, you know, director of comedy and all that, that's not just like some phony title. You know, you really are the director of comedy. She's in charge of getting the comedians down here. You've been just giving us one great comic after another. We really appreciate that.
So much talent in New England. It's easy. It's easy with all the talent that we have here.
Well, speaking of talent with a capital T, why don't we have a nice New Bedford welcome? This gentleman drove from about an hour and 40 minutes away to be with us here tonight on the Paul Santos Live TV show. So let's give him that big new beige welcome. Here's Jerry Caruso.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. How you doing tonight? Everybody doing good? Give it up for Paul. Give it up for Allison, the guy with the guitar. That's my time. I always tell people the truth about me. I was born with a lazy eye. When I was 8 years old, I got my whole family and friends in the room, tell them, lazy eye, no meds, no surgery, no doctors, no ophthalmologist, just take me the way I am. This is the way God made me. Back in the room, my Uncle Mario says, hey, Jerry, we're right with you. By the way, we're over here. Then my lovely wife I met, she met me a long time ago, like 40 years ago. I go, I love you, I want to marry you, we're dating, but something stopped me. She goes, what's that? I go, the eye. She goes, what about the eye? I go, no meds, no surgery. I got a lazy eye, no ophthalmologist. She said, I still love you. We got married. We're married 40 years, which is great. However, my angel forgets about the lazy eye. Tonight, I hug her, kiss her goodbye, tell her I love her. She thinks I'm seeing someone on the side. I'm telling you. Jerks, you laugh. 100% Italian. Any Italians in the audience? I didn't think so. All right. 30 years plus I've been doing comedy. My Italian mother has not seen one show. I said, Mama, come see me do comedy. She goes, no. I said, why? She goes, because of that laugh for you. That's the joke. That's the joke. I was brave. I was the youngest Italian that people know that moved out of their house for all the families that we knew. When I was 40, everybody was shocked. When I was 40, everyone was shocked. No, I'm just kidding. And I remember the night I told my mother, she's crying. She goes, so no, Jenny, please and don't go. I said, Mama, I got a good job. I got a nice apartment. I got a used car. I'm going to night school. Why are you going to go? I said, Ma, look, oh, my leg, I'm moving upstairs. Oh, my God. So I love being Italian so much. I have my own theme song. You guys like Queen? You guys like Queen?
Yeah, yeah.
Here's my theme song for being Italian. We wear gold chains. We got a very small brains. Got an uncle named Bob. He's got an old job. He works for the mob. We all got big noses. Grab ourselves, we do. Got an apartment of our own above mom and pop. On floor two, and we drive I rocks. We are Italians, my friends, and we love the girls with big rear ends. We are Italians, we love our scallions, goombas and paisans, because we are Italians, we love girls. So I've done big shows, folks. I've done I did a synagogue 6 years into the business. I was scared. And the woman goes, just be funny, do Jewish jokes. I go, I got none. She goes, go write some. I had an hour. I come back with the following. Woman at the synagogue goes, would you like a yarmulke? And I got a Toyota. I'm all set. And then did a Beatles tune for her and for the crowd in Jewish. But I won't get into that because I can't do it on the show. So, okay. We're like passing out. Today, I went to Walmart. Who goes to Walmart? Admit it, we go. What do you hate about Walmart? Self-serve cashiers. I don't want to do it. I got to the cashier, and the woman up front staring at me, the friendly woman from Walmart, and I said, oh, I just want to get out of here. I rang the first item. I got no bags. I look at her. I says, I got no bags. She goes, stock room, the far left, go get some. And while you're there, get some for registers 17, 19, 23, 24, and 37. I go, oh, my God. I get back, get the bags. I says, I just want to get out of here. I rang the second item, put it in the bag. I'm happy. Third item, so on. Fourth item didn't ring up. I go, oh, no. I look at her. I go, price check. She goes, that item is in aisle 14 on the lower left. You'll see it there. Folks, I run back. By the time I get back, I got a Walmart vest on. I got badges. I'm employee of the month. And I'm on Walmart radio tomorrow. Bad part about it is I got a cover for Chelsea at the service desk on Saturday. Jeez. So anyway, I love music, which give a hand for the guy earlier. He was really good, so he was nice. Yeah. I do a lot of songs on aging rock and roll bands that are in their 50s, 60s, and 70s. They still sing about sex, drugs, and rock and roll. I say change the words around to accommodate us baby boomers. I mean, think about it. Meatloaf, you took my dentures out of my mouth.
That is a good one. That's a good one. That's a good one.
One of my favorite ones is Metallica or Bob Seger. As I walk down to the mailbox, what do I see? A coupon for some denture cream, a card from AARP. So I say to myself, you're elderly. Well, here I am, I've got to go again. Here I am, while I'm up on the stage. There I go, in my adult diapers again. And I know it's old age. Isn't that good? That's not bad, that's not bad. One last thing, I do a lot of nonprofit things, and one of my favorite things is entertaining patients, like cancer patients and people in rehab. So I had to do Spalding Rehab 5 years ago. I remember this well. Loved it. I did an hour. It was nice. It was funny. It made people laugh. But I want to leave on a high note because I look around at people in crutches, wheelchairs, missing limbs. So what do I say? I look at the crowd. I say, I hope you guys and girls get better. Guy in a wheelchair against the wall looks at me and goes, you too. So I'm not going back there. My name is Jerry Caruso. Good night. God bless you all. I'm going to take a seat.
Jerry, thank you very much for coming down. Grab a seat.
You're welcome. Good to see you.
Wow, an hour and 40 minutes to be with us tonight. Thank you so much.
That's awesome. Allison. That's Allison.
That's Allison.
No, it's well worth it. This is a great show. You got a good thing going here.
Yeah,
you know?
Thank you very much. We're having a lot of fun, that's
nice.
For sure.
Yeah, it is.
Really appreciate you coming down. So I know you, right? I can tell that you're a real pro, right? So
I love it.
This has been going on for a long time. And not only comedy, but you're an actor, right?
Yeah, I act for Murder Mystery. But when I got unemployed in year 2001, I had nowhere to go. Boston Casting called me and said, oh, look, we need someone to be a detective. I go, I don't act. They go, don't worry about it. So I get there, and they go, we want an Italian guy who's a wise ass. I go, oh, God, I'd be myself then, right? So I've been doing it ever since, and it's so much fun.
Gee, that's great. Being an actor, how is that different than, you know, going up there and doing a set of comedy?
Well, I try to do improv with the crowds. I don't use any of my jokes. I just talk to the crowd and work off of them. You know, like doing crowd work, like where you're from, what's your name, and if I know where they're from, I tell them things about the town. They go, how do you know this? I go, I'm a cop. That's my job. So it's really cool.
Yeah,
so
nice,
it really works out well, yeah.
So tell me about your comedy. You travel around and
I'm all over New England. Yeah. One of my passions is Comics for a Cure, where I just do benefits and fundraisers since 1994, and I love doing it. It's just the best feeling, just to give back, you know?
Yeah.
Make people laugh. One of my favorite shows, I do monthly shows at Hope Lodge in Boston. Allison came once. It's such a rewarding experience. Meet some of the nicest people. If you can get them away from what they go through, chemotherapy and radiation for 1 hour, it just gets me here. That's all
nice,
I need
nice.
To
do.
Nice,
very rewarding work.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now,
so
as far as your material, right, do you come up with stuff that happened to you in your life, or do you look for stuff? Do you write all of the above? How does it work?
all of the above, but it's mostly about me because no one can get after me. Like, oh, you made fun of. I said, yeah, me. I'm not making fun of anybody else.
Right, right.
I try not to tool on my family too much. Like, it's all nice stuff about my family, so nobody could turn around and say, oh, my God, was that mean? I try not to be. I just try to make it fun and just try to reach out to people because when I tell jokes, they can relate to it. So if I talk about storing food in the basement, people are like, we did that too. You don't have to be Italian to store food in the basement. Everybody did that a long time ago. I say a long time ago because I mean it's 68. Oh, my God.
That's 68?
I'm 68.
Oh, wow. Wow. You're looking great, man. You're looking great.
Someone took me for 67 out there. No. A girl in the street took me for 50. No, that's a bad joke. Glad you got that. You got that, too. That's a great joke.
I like that's that a great joke.
That's
yeah.
a great joke. I love it. I love it.
So what's going on in your future? You out on the road and you got some shows coming up and stuff like that?
Yeah, I got a lot of shows coming up. I continue to do Hope Lodge in Boston with my friend Paul Durant. Sometimes a guest like Allison comes along, which is really cool. I do that every month. I'm doing a lot of senior shows. I'm headed out to Albany, New York to do something for the Relay for Life. It's funny, I put in stuff in Relay for Life Facebook saying, anybody needs comedy for fundraising, call me. I'll work out a deal with you. I get calls from Michigan, New York, New Jersey, and Australia. Nothing from Massachusetts, nothing from New England. I go figure, but I've done so many for them.
Right,
but it's
right,
fun.
Right.
I like doing that. I'm doing a lot of those. I may be doing another one in Connecticut for another Relay for Life group. I'm just everywhere. I'm doing like a show on Mohegan Sun for a social workers group. It's actually my niece, but they wanted me because they saw me do a show. So it's, you know, tons of fun. It's like,
it is.
And I just got asked to go back to talk to Salem State University, the occupational therapy conference, where I'm talking about laughter is the best medicine, clean jokes, and the health benefits of laughter. I can do that for an hour. I'm Italian. If you tie up my hands, I can't talk. But you leave my hands free, I could talk forever. So.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, we really appreciate you stopping by. You know, you're talking about poking fun of yourself. I try to do that. That way I don't run out of material, you know?
Yeah, you won't
run out of material.
Jerry Caruso, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
We're back with more of the Paul Sanchez Live Show. Stay with
Thank
us.
You.
A great singer, Skylar Swaya, is up next. We'll be right back. Shout out to Roger Brightman, who's watching at home. He said he wanted to come down but couldn't make it, but he's watching at home, so that's okay. Hey, Roger.
This is my coach, Roger, right? My coach.
Marie Scrivano says, Jerry Caruso, love the parody songs. Shout out to Nicholas Medeiros, sounds like a Portuguese person. And Mike Keating, thanks for looking in tonight. All right, we like to put the spotlight on young up-and-coming talent, especially people who are really talented and they're honing their craft. They are improving every day, and they are great to spotlight here on the show. Could you please put your hands together for our next guest, Skylar Swaya?
Hi, everyone.
So alive, turns out I'm not real, just
There's something you paid for. What was I made for? 'Cause I don't know how to feel, but I wanna try.
Squire. Hey, that was fantastic.
Thank
Grab
you.
A seat. Thank you so much for coming down. Wow, that was fantastic.
I had to jump on here. Okay.
There you go. Now we're talking. Now we're talking. Well, thank you very much for stopping down.
Thank
tonight.
You
that
so
was
much
fantastic.
For having me. It was really fun.
Oh, my God. So how long have you been doing this? I mean, you nailed that song.
I've been doing this with Sharon since I was
Sharon
6
Jensen.
Years old.
Let's hear it for Sharon Jensen.
Yes.
The voice coach, so 6 years old to yeah. now, and you're a teenager, right?
Mm-hmm. I'm 17 years
so
old.
So this is 11 years or so?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, that's great. So tell me about this. Tell me about what you've learned over the years as far as honing your craft.
Yeah. I've learned speech. I've learned pronunciation. I'm still working
that was
on
perfect.
That
I can put that in the monologue. That was great.
I've learned performing. I've learned how to... Breast support, I learned a lot from Sharon, and I'm really grateful for that.
Absolutely. Let's hear it
yeah.
for Sharon.
Yeah.
And I'm learning a lot, too, from Sharon, and she's an outstanding teacher. So you are also, I'm not going to believe this, she's a singer. She's also yes. an actress.
Yes, I am. Yes.
So wait a minute. Singer and actress? Wow, that's like a 1-2 punch here.
Yep.
Tell me about that. What's going on with that?
Well, I've been getting into acting since I was also little, too, and I love... combining them. It's really my passion, and I'm really excited to pursue that when I'm older also.
Now, you're a student of New Bedford High School?
Yes.
All right, and you're in, what is it, the drama club?
Yes, I am.
And you got a big show coming up, right?
Yep.
Tell me
yes.
about that. This is two shows in one.
Yes.
Something a little different this time
yes.
around. How does that work?
Okay, so act one, it's a little hard to explain, so hang in there. It's a combination it's a combination of show choir and also the other drama students, and it's supposed to be like a walking through New York, and it's a bunch of musicals from different songs from different musicals mm-hmm. basically combined with snippets of lines together, and also the show choir piece.
Nice.
Yes.
So Gee, that's fantastic.
Thank you.
So it really is centered around people visiting New York City to see Broadway shows. That is kind of like the theme of it. And
yes.
then Six to Teen Edition.
Yes.
So that's fantastic. Mm-hmm. That's a good. Who came up with that idea? That's something different.
Yeah, because it's six for Act Two, and that's only six members. So we wanted to include everyone and have Act One be everyone included.
Nice.
Also, yes. Yes.
So what year are you in at the high school now?
I am a junior.
A junior. Okay.
Yes.
Do you have any idea what you might want to do after high school? I know
yes.
it's a little ways ahead.
I want to become a therapist and most likely in a school to help kids with their lives and at home and during school also.
See, that's
yeah.
great. That's a great.
Yeah.
You know, I'm an attorney by day and I do a lot of work in juvenile court. And I know a lot of educators. You got a lot of educators
yes,
here tonight.
Yes, I do.
I mean, helping out kids that are having issues, they need that.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's a great career. I think that's a good choice.
Yeah.
By the way, speaking of family, you got a whole bunch of people here tonight supporting
yes,
you.
Yes, thank you.
So who do we got? We got mom and dad, right?
Mm-hmm. I have my grandma, Sharon, and my mom's teacher's friends that I've known for years. Yeah.
That's awesome. Now, do you have any siblings, any brothers or sisters?
No,
or,
I'm
oh, you're
the
only
child.
Child.
Yes.
All right, nice. All right. So that, hey, you know, you don't have to worry about arguing with the siblings.
No,
you know?
It's just me.
Hey, it's all about you.
Yep. It's all about me.
So what's coming up after you do this show? Is there anything else on the horizon that you're working on, or?
Show choir is also presenting a cabaret with some students perform solos and some of all togetherness again.
All right. Now, if people want to see the show that's coming up, the
mm-hmm.
one we talked about before,
yes.
the New York City Broadway one and Six and all that, how do they
yeah.
get tickets?
They get tickets from the website yeah. ourshow.com/NBHS review and six.
All right. Nice.
And well. You also can get a $2 fee because you get a fee on the website and in person. And you can get that off with the code SANTOSSHOW in all caps. For to get that off.
Ah,
yes. Yes.
All right. That's what we're talking about there. That's what we're talking about. Got a little Caruso, a little Portuguese in there. No, forget about the Italians. So what else is going on? Are you like a student that likes a particular class, or, you know, are you really good in a particular, like whether it's language or English or anything else in school besides, you know, the singing?
Yeah, I also really love ELA, and I also like taking the theater classes and show choir classes.
Nice, nice. Yeah. I bet you do. I bet you do.
Yeah.
Any songs you're working on? I know that was a great job, but
thank
you know, Sharon's
you.
Always trying to push us, you know, to try to do new stuff.
Yeah.
So, you got any new stuff that you're working on that we haven't, you know, heard in public yet?
I'm doing my solo for the six, but I can't sing that unfortunately because of rights. But I would have loved to sing that song.
Oh.
Yes.
Well,
but
you know, you got the big shots, you know, and they get the lawyers in there.
Yeah,
and
I know.
They screw the whole thing up, you know what I
yeah.
mean?
The watchdogs are all over the place.
They're looking because we're actually one of the first people to do six teen edition because the regular six is very risque, so it's not really
oh.
for like teens.
Yeah.
So they made a teen version, but wow. we're actually one of the first people to do it in the country. So it's really exciting.
That's
yeah.
great.
Hey, Gary, didn't you see the original version not that long ago? I think you did. Yeah, I think you saw
yeah.
the original.
As a matter of fact, I did, and she's absolutely right. It's yeah. not appropriate for teenagers whatsoever.
Hey, you're an absolute delight coming on down here. We got to
thank
Sharon
much.
For suggesting you. We're always looking for great
thank
guests.
So
Sharon
much.
Always gives us some great guests.
Yeah.
So thank you very much for coming down.
Thank
Skyla
so
Swire, thank you so
you.
Much again.
Thank you.
Thank you. We'll be right back with more of the Paul Santos Live Show. Stay right where you are.
Thank you so much.
All right, one of our viewers says to our last guest, beautiful voice you have, beautiful voice, and she's absolutely correct. Well, you're not going to believe this, ladies and gentlemen, but I'm looking at the clock here. We have about 3 minutes left. Ordinarily, we just kind of like, you know, kill off a few minutes and all that, but I hear some noises backstage. Hear those noises backstage?
Yeah, I did.
I hear somebody like trying to scratch their way onto the stage.
It can only be one person.
It can only be one person.
That's right. Moscow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Crazy Casey.
Mr. Casey. Hey, Big Daddy. Love you, Big Daddy.
Wow, this is like 3 weeks in a row you made it on. That's pretty good, huh?
It just shows you how desperate you're getting.
I love that I'm the only one who got that.
Every week, I realize I think of something every time I come here on a Monday night. What's missing in my life? And I'm not talking about personal satisfactions or
what have you.
I'm talking about body parts. Sometimes I think every Monday night's like a rehearsal for Halloween.
Wait a minute. You're missing body parts?
As you would ask me that, let me tell you what. My body parts, I don't even know how many we're supposed to have anymore. When I go to the airport, I have to sort them out by whatever they're made of. And I had cheap doctors. I think my hips made a cherise.
Well, I'm glad to see that you're moving around effortlessly and stuff.
Oh, yeah, effortlessly. Hey, I want to tell you, I really enjoyed that gentleman over there.
Caruso?
I love his name.
Caruso, yeah.
I always loved that name Caruso because of the great singer Caruso. But when he said that he does a lot of nonprofit, boy, do you fit in here.
Yeah, I can say that. Amen to that.
Hey, Allison, when's the last time you got paid?
She's a sponsor. She actually pays to be on the show.
Wait a minute.
How about
that? You're a contributor. You know, at the end of the show, where the credits go by, and we say, goodwill contributor.
And you're a perpetrator.
Hey, Big Daddy, I think you're more of an unindicted co-conspirator.
Well, he used to be a prostitute for the DA.
No, prosecutor.
He's a prosecutor, not a prostitute.
I'm sorry.
Are you stumbling over yourself?
No, I'm not. I've been stumbling over a lot of things lately.
All right, remember?
And most of them are about bodies, because I'm back at Metamucil Manor. I tell you. Well, I'm planning the Easter egg. We have an Easter hunt. We don't have an egg hunt. We have two groups. We give everybody Red Bull. We send one group out. Then we send a second group out to find them.
You remember I said there was 3 minutes left? That's the end of the 3 minutes.
I just mean I'm working overtime.
Ladies and gentlemen, Crazy Casey.
With all your thrills upon it.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our guests once again. How about Roger Chatier? How about the outstanding singing of Skylar Swire? Thank you so much for coming. And last but not least, the funny comedy of Jerry Caruso.
Check one.
And of course, our director of comedy, Allison Dian. And we can't do the show without the best band in all the land,
yeah.
Gary Hardy, the PSL Band. Oh,
thank
yeah.
you, Paul. Good night, everybody. Thanks for coming.
Next week, we'll be right back here at Mikey B's. We hope to see you then. I'm Paul Santos for the Paul Santos Live Show. Don't forget to laugh and have a great night, everybody.
In your Easter bonnet, with all your thrills upon it, they'll be coming down on the Easter parade. Wear your bit of bonnet in your Easter bonnet. We'll be coming down the Easter parade. Right.